Hello guys, and welcome in another tutorial. Today we are going to see how to add alpha output using the color tab in DaVinci Resolve 16 and then export the transparent background video using the QuickTime format so that we can use that video in other projects in the future. So let's get started. As you can see, I'm in DaVinci Resolve 16. I have already imported some media here. There are two videos I will be using, and those are the planet and tunnel, which I have downloaded from the page pixabay.com. First thing I will do today is add this planet to the timeline. And what we want to do here is remove the sky behind it, or the black background, and just isolate the spinning earth. So we will move to the color tab, and this video is pretty simple because we don't have any other movement. We just have the earth spinning in place. So all we have to do is just isolate the earth and apply the alpha output. If you're not in the window tab, make sure you select it, and then since the earth is a circle, we will select the circle tool. Now the earth is selected. We need to make a proper selection. This red outline circle changes the softness of the selection. You can change the softness from here, or if you go down here, you can do that from this part by moving, dragging the mouse left and right. Let's zoom in and make sure that you select the earth entirely. And now to add the alpha output, go to the nodes section, right click, and add alpha output. As you can see, a node is added, a blue node is added. I go to this blue rectangle here, click and drag it and connect it to this node over here, and now the alpha output is added. If you go in the edit page of DaVinci Resolve, if I play it, this is what we will see. Now to render it out or export it, we go to the render page. In the renderer part, you will select the individual clips for the format, so make sure to select the QuickTime, and then we will select the DNxHR codec, and for the type we will select the DNxHR HQ. DNxHR HQ means high quality. You can select also the standard quality type or the low bandwidth, or you can go higher and select the HQX, which is usually used for 4K resolution, or the DNxHR 444 12-bit type, which is usually used in the cinematic very high quality videos. For us will be enough to select the DNxHR HQ high quality, because we are working in full HD resolution. And then in the resolution part, you can check the rendered source solution if you want, but the resolution down here, or you can choose another resolution if you like, but we will stick with the 1920 to 1080 HD. And also make sure it's very important to select the export alpha mode. When you check the export alpha box, then a new drop down appears, the alpha mode. You have two selections here, pre-multiple and straight. To go real quick, with the straight or unmatted channels, the transparency information is stored only in the alpha channel, not in any of the visible color channels. While with the pre-multiple or matted channels, the transparency information is stored in the alpha channel and also in the visible RGB channels, which are multiplied with a background color. My suggestion would be experiment with these two modes and then see which one better applies for your project. I will go with a pre-multiple alpha mode, and then we don't have to do anything. We can leave it as it is in the advanced settings section. The reason why we are exporting this video is that we want to use this transparent background earth, spinning earth, in other projects as well, potentially outside DaVinci Resolve. So now to render, go and hit add to render queue. Make sure you have named the file and chosen the location. I will type pre-multiple here and add it to the render queue and start rendering. Now the rendering is done. We will go and delete this from here. I will add the tunnel. If I add the video which doesn't have the alpha output applied, this is what we get. You cannot see the background, the tunnel background. But if we go and import the file we just exported, which is this one, and add it on top of the tunnel video, then you can see the tunnel behind the earth, which is the effect we wanted to achieve. Check my other DaVinci Resolve tutorials by clicking in the card above. I would be glad to hear from you, so write your comments, critics or questions in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button so that you are notified whenever I post a new video. And thank you for watching this video. See you next time. Bye.